But I was just home visiting my parents. I don't know if anybody feels like this. When I go home, I'm okay for like 6 minutes. And then I feel weirdly furious. And then I feel guilty about the level of hostility that I'm feeling. And then I just eat a lot of bread. I just bread my way through the weekend. It's a lot going home. My mother is intense. She's aggressively liberal. Like, my mom's dream for me, I think, would be if I married a Nigerian lesbian. I think that's what she wants. She was praying that one of us was gay. That's all she's ever wanted, just one gay kid. She was just sitting in the kitchen waiting. Like, there's Coco if anyone feels gay and wants to talk about it. And whenever she visits me in New York, she always tries to bond with the cab driver and apologize for Trump. It's so awkward. And she loves to read their name tag in a cab. She likes to kind of bite into an ethnic name and honor it. It's so gross. She'll be like, excuse me, Sarah Hanjay. What a marvelous name. What region is that? I'm like, he's not a wine. He's a man, Karen. Leave him alone. The worst part of his day is that you have access to his name right now. She's always wearing some long menopausal cape, just some sort of Navajo smock, just smocking around. And she'll be like, I just want to say, Sarah Hanjay, that I am so sorry for some of these awful things that President Trump has said about Muslims. I'm like, that's not even the good way to say it. She says it in the racist way when she's trying to build bridges. She'll be like, we think Muslims are fantastic, Sarah Hanj. And you are welcome in our neighborhood anytime. He's just glaring at her like, I'm Sikh, you white bitch. Get out of my cab. Yeah, it was a lot being home. My dad's on Facebook. I don't know if anybody has a parent active on Facebook, but it's very upsetting. His profile picture, my dad's, is so alarming. He's just sort of glaring into the distance. I'm like, why would he choose that picture? He has this strange, haunting expression. And then he writes these long, political, unstable rants. And he doesn't understand how to edit what he's written, so he edits by putting a comment beneath what he just wrote in the comment section. He'll be like, I want to apologize, but in the passion of my earlier statement, I'm afraid I misspelled the following words. And then he likes his own comment and lists all the words that he's misspelled in the comment section. And then my mom likes to log in and use my dad's Facebook. She goes, me and your father, we share a Facebook page. I'm like, that's not a thing. You either have Facebook or you don't. Dad has his own demonic page and that's his. And she goes, well, I like to log into your father's page because I need to tell all your girlfriends when they look gorgeous in their photos. Yes. So it just looks like my father is hitting on all my friends. Anytime any of my girlfriends post a picture of themselves, my mom will leap onto my dad's page and be like, my goodness, what a foxy figure you have, Lisa. I refuse to believe you just had a baby, not with that smoking hot fetching bad. You are a real dish. And then there's my dad just glaring with this chilling expression. It looks like he's seducing all my friends. So I did that. I've done that joke on stage, and I was like afraid of my dad finding it online. So I was like, I should probably tell my dad about that joke. So I sat him down. I was trying to explain it to him. I'm like, Dad, just so you know, I was like, I have this joke about you and your Facebook. And he goes, oh, that's great. I'll share it on Facebook. My mom was like, you shouldn't tell that part on stage. That's not nice. Take it out of your talent show. That's what she calls my stand-up, my talent show. Thank you guys so much. That's it for me. Thank you.